Good morning, everybody. I'm Ilaria Benucci and I come from Tushai University. Today I would like to present you my research concerning the application of a fluidized bed reactor containing an immobilized protease for the reduction of gluten beer from barley malt. Beer is the alcoholic beverage most consumed all over the world, with an average annual consumption of about 86 kg pro capita in North America and 74 kg pro capita in Europe. The European beer market is the second in the world, with an estimated value of about 545 million hectoliters. Celiac disease is most common in the Caucasian population, especially in Western Europe and in North America. And people affected by celiac disease represent about 3% of the global population. In addition, about 6% of the world population has gluten sensitivity, and more than 23% avoids or reduces the consumption of food containing gluten by personal choice. And consumers affected by celiac disease must adhere to a gluten-free diet. The Codex Alimentarius Standard and the European Regulation 828/2014 established a gluten concentration below 20 mg per kilogram for gluten-free food, whereas the range of gluten content in brewed barley malt beers may vary from 10 to 4,000 mg per kilogram in some industrial beers. For this reason, consumers affected by celiac disease can safely drink only beer surrogates, which significantly differ from authentic beer in terms of aroma and taste. In the last decade, the demand for high-quality gluten-free food, including gluten-free beer, has greatly increased, and their production is becoming an important socio-economic issue. Despite the fact that beer is not an essential part of nutrition, the availability of safe, healthy, and tasty gluten-free beer would appreciably improve people's well-being and attitudes toward a normal social life. Thus, in this context, the main strategies for producing gluten-free beer are the use of naturally gluten-free grains, such as rice, corn, sorghum, and millet, or pseudo-cereals, such as quinoa, buckwheat, and amaranth as raw materials, but also the precipitation of proteins using tannins, silica gel, or PVPP, and finally, the degradation of gluten during the brewing process by the addition of enzymes, such as protease. In this context, this study was aimed to develop a continuous treatment for the production of gluten-free conventional barley malt beer by using a fluidized bed reactor containing a prolyl endopeptidase covalently mobilized on food-grade carriers. A commercial prolyl endopeptidase was covalently mobilized on food-grade carriers produced in our laboratory starting from chitosan powder of microbial origin. The amount of enzyme loaded on the supports was evaluated by the Bradford assay, which was carried out on the mobilization solution before and after the incubation with chitosan carriers. The proteolytic activity of free and immobilized protease was evaluated in synthetic beer toward a dipeptide chromogenic substrate containing glycine and proline, thus mimicking the linkages in gluten. The hydrolysis of the synthetic substrate by free or immobilized protease resulted in the release of free paranitroaniline, which was monitored spectrophotometrically at 410 nanometer, measuring the change in absorbance in 10 minutes. This graph shows the optimization of the mobilization protocol. Different trials have been conducted varying the initial protein concentration in the mobilization solution containing the protease and evaluating the protein loading on the columns, as well as the specific activity of the mobilized biocatalyst line on the chart. Observing the columns, the increase of the initial protein concentration in the mobilization solution resulted in a gradual increase of protein loading, which reached the maximum value of 7 mg of BSA equivalent per gram of carrier when the initial protein concentration in the mobilization solution was 3 mg per milliliter, with no further increase, thus indicating the saturation of the support. Observing the effect of the initial protein concentration in the mobilization solution on the specific activity, thus observing the line on the chart, we can see that the increase of the initial protein concentration in the mobilization solution resulted in a gradual significant increase of the specific activity, which reached the maximum value when the initial protein concentration was 0.3 mg per kilogram, followed by a significant reduction of the specific activity, probably due to steric hindrance resulting from the mobilization of a greater amount of proteins. This slide shows the influence of temperature and pH on the activity of free and immobilized protease in model beer toward the substrate mimicking gluten. It was found that the optimum temperature for the enzyme in the free form was 60 degrees Celsius, whereas after immobilization, the optimal temperature was 50 degrees Celsius. The effect of different pH values was investigated both at 20 degrees Celsius, which is the temperature conventionally applied in brewing during the post-fermentation step, as well as at the optimal temperature for free and immobilized enzymes. Regardless of the temperature, immobilized protease maintained a suitable proteolytic activity in the typical range of beer pH, showing the optimum pH from 4.2 to 4.5. The kinetic curves obtained for free and immobilized protease show that both biocatalysts followed the hyperbolic behavior of the Michaelis-Menten equation. As expected, the immobilization strongly reduced the catalytic properties of immobilized protease, as you can see from the corresponding curves obtained in model beer at 20 degrees Celsius and at their respective optimal temperature. The corresponding estimated kinetic parameters show that the best catalytic performances were revealed for the protease in free form at its optimal temperature, which correspond to 60 degrees Celsius. A significant reduction of catalytic activity was revealed when the free protease was applied at 20 degrees Celsius. Concerning the immobilized protease, it is interesting to highlight that no significant differences in the kinetic parameters were observed applying the enzyme at its optimal temperature with respect to 20 degrees Celsius, thus suggesting that immobilized protease had a reduced proteolytic stabilization. Moreover, immobilized protease has the greatest affinity for the substrate, both at 20 degrees Celsius and at its optimal temperature. The fluidized bed reactor consisted of a cylindrical glass column equipped with an external water jacket for the temperature control and connected to a thermostat. The use of a peristaltic pump and the simultaneous nitrogen gas insufflation from the bottom of the column allowed the resuspension of the immobilized biocatalyst, as well as the recirculation of the synthetic or authentic beer. Process parameters were optimized at 20 degrees Celsius in synthetic and in authentic beer, varying the flow rate, since this parameter changing resulted in a corresponding variation of the other process parameters, in particular phase velocity, residence time, and product formation rate. The immobilized protease showed a satisfactory proteolytic activity both in synthetic and in authentic beer, fortified with the synthetic substrate. In both medium, the increase of flow rate resulted in a corresponding increase of the product formation rate, which in authentic beer resulted to be the highest at a flow rate of 728 milliliters per minute. The further increase of flow rate at values higher than 728 milliliters per minute resulted in an evident reduction of the product formation rate, probably due to the greater turbulence at high flow rates, as well as to the reduction of contact time between the mobilized protease and the substrate, leading to a decrease of the product formation rate. Thus, the suitable flow rate in order to achieve the gluten reduction in authentic beer throughout treatment in fluidized bed reactor was 728 milliliters per minute. In the final step of the procedure, a Pilsner type beer was treated in the fluidized bed reactor containing 10 grams of immobilized protease at the suitable flow rate. The continuous process was conducted at 20 degrees Celsius for 10 hours, and its efficiency in gluten reduction was evaluated collecting 1 milliliter of treated beer at regular time intervals for the quantification throughout ELISA competitive kit. The initial gluten content of the Pilsner type beer slowly reduced until reaching the level of 19 milligrams per kilogram after 9 hours and 15 milligrams per kilogram after 10 hours of treatment. Immobilized protease applied in the continuous fluidized bed reactor was able to reduce the gluten content at a concentration lower than 20 milligrams per kilogram, which corresponds to the amount established by the Codex Alimentarius Standard and the European regulation for gluten-free food. Thus, in conclusion, the protease was successfully immobilized on food-grade carriers, and the continuous treatment in fluidized bed reactor allowed us to reduce the gluten content in the commercial beer from barley malt under the level requested for gluten-free food. Finally, from an industrial point of view, this preliminary study offers an innovative and sustainable biocatalytic approach for the continuous production of gluten-free beer. And thanks for your attention.